Hey folks, it's Eugene, and today what I'm going to be doing is talking about what you need to get started with a basic kit using Recon 3D. So there's a number of different things I have on the table here, and I'm going to go through them sort of one by one and really just focus in on the basics for the most part. Just want you to know there are a ton of accessories and things, and you can spend hours online just searching through a whole number of different things. So I'm going to narrow it down to just a few basic tools and maybe give you a couple of options, but then that's about it. So the first thing that I want to talk about is what device you're going to use. Okay, so that's the most important thing. Probably most people are using the phones. So, you know, I have a 12 Pro, I've got a 15 Pro, any of the Pro and Pro Max versions of the phone, including the 16 Pro Max, which is coming out pretty soon, will all be capable of running Recon 3D. It has the sensor and you're good to go. There are people who do use an iPad, and if you are going to use an iPad, you just need to think about why you're getting it. Okay, with the phone, it's small, it fits into an adapter, a selfie stick, it's really simple to use, you can get it up in the air. You can do that with an iPad, no problem. But of course, it's a little bit more difficult to sort of get it up high, it's a little heavier, and it is a little bit more expensive than a phone. So, you know, you need to think about that. What would be the advantage of what would be the advantages of having an iPad over an iPhone? So usually what I tell people is, if you're gonna be processing on the device, okay, so if you're mostly gonna be running the processing algorithm to get the scan file on the iPad, there are some processing advantages. You know, bigger screen is nice, but of course it has more memory often, and it even has a better processor, so it can do a lot more on the device itself. However, you can do quite a lot with the phone as well, and if you're using the iPad for other things, so if you're using it for work email, maybe you're using it for a tablet for your drone or something like that, then the iPad might make sense, okay? Both will work, but like I said, if we're just talking about scanning itself and what is the most convenient, I think the phone is the way to go. And of course, you don't have to buy the latest and greatest. You can buy an older phone. So I just want people to know that there are some Recon 3D users that are Android users, but they go ahead and they buy a phone that's just dedicated to scanning. Okay, when it comes to the phones, you do want to get a good case. Okay, so this one is just a clear case. It's got the MagSafe on the back. This 12 Pro has just like a silicone case, just something to help protect it. You know, you don't want to be scratching it, especially if you're going to be moving it around on a selfie stick. So I like to have a case on there. In the case of an iPad, you know, you could use something like this, and you know, it has a protective cover and everything else. And this is fairly heavy duty, even has a strap. You can, you know, put it around your neck. So that's really just up to you and what your preference is. There are tons of these things online, so you can have at it and you know, waste a lot of time looking for what you like and what color and everything else. Once you have got that going, we want to talk about adapters, okay? So let me just take care of the iPad first. If you are looking for an adapter that, you know, mounts across here, get a really heavy duty one, a sturdy one. The iPad is a lot of money, so you don't want it sliding out of the adapter. But they do sell adapters that you can put in. I don't have mine here with me. I tend not to use the iPad, especially when I'm elevating it. It's strictly for me, it's just, you know, kind of on the ground. But you can buy an adapter, and then you're gonna wanna get a really, really solid pole for it, okay? But I'm not gonna touch on a lot of that right now. The other thing is the phone adapter. So there are a wide variety of phone adapters. And when I started with some plastic adapters. So here we go. I've got one here and I've got one here. Let me unscrew that. So here are a couple. These are just plastic adapters. They're okay. This one here, for example, is very, very basic. It basically just has something that you can loosen and tighten around the phone, and then around the back, it's got a little screw kind of thing that you can just rotate this around if you want to go to landscape or portrait mode, okay? Now, I don't like these very much because if you look at them, they actually bend, and when the phone is sitting here on a pole, I find that they wobble a little bit, okay? This is another one. It's not too bad. This one's from Lanzi. It has a little swivel, so if you want to tilt it, that's kind of nice. Okay, that's an option. But there's a ton of these. I tend to stay away from plastic. That's the bottom line. Okay, I don't know what it is, but I just find that plastic, they can work. I use these before and I have a bunch kicking around. Sometimes they come in other kits and things like that, but I prefer metal. And so you can really go all out and you get like these little metal cages that are used for video and stabilization and stuff like that. So this one would work, something like that. But I have a couple that I've settled on, which are pretty good to me. And one of them is is this one here, okay? So this one is actually made from Neewer, N-E-E-W-E-R, and what I like about this one is it is all metal. It has a screw here so you can tilt this back and forth, okay, like this, and you can also swivel it. It has a hot shoe mount, and it has the quarter 20 thread on the bottom, plus it has a hot shoe mount on the back, one on this side, and one on that side, okay? So that's useful to me. It also has a little screw back here, and basically if you loosen this up, you can turn this and it kind of clicks into sort of preset positions, so it's nice and firm, okay? It's not gonna wobble around or loosen on you. And it comes integrated with a Allen key here, so if this ever loosens up, you can definitely tighten it up again. One thing about this is that there's two little screws, okay, or like pins, they're threaded pins that go through here, and that's what is sort of spring-loaded and gives you this extension. I've used this a lot, and these have come loose on me before. So what I would recommend here is to get a little bit of Loctite. You can just unscrew these, put some of the Loctite on the end, and then tighten it back up, then it won't move, okay? Those pins are gonna stay in there for a very, very long time, and you won't have to worry about losing anything. But Loctite you can pick up anywhere online, Amazon, whatever. It's a few dollars, but it'll do the trick for sure. So that's the phone adapter. There are others that I use that maybe don't have some of these integrated swivels and things like that, but again, go nuts on Amazon and or wherever, and you're good to go. Okay, let's switch over to the selfie sticks, because I think this is going to be an important one too. There are a number that I have here, a whole bunch, but the one that I sort of go-to is this one here, okay? So this is a Manfrotto selfie stick, and I'll show you the others in a second, but this one is just, it's relatively compact, and this is why I like it. So it just, it's infinitely adjustable, so in between these positions, so I can kind of go here, lock it, and it's nice and firm. It's made of a metal, okay? So I don't know exactly which metal it's made it from, I could probably check that, but it could be some kind of alloy, aluminum alloy, or magnesium alloy, or something like that. And it has a little quarter 20 thread here, and a quarter 20 thread here. So there's a little cap, and you can unscrew this, and then you get the little quarter 20 thread here. Little note, this little cap, if you're not careful, it falls out, and so I've almost lost this twice, okay? So just be careful. But this particular Manfrotto, they've changed the name on it from when I originally bought it, so it may be called a Selfie Stick VR or something like that. You'll have to check it, but that's the one, okay, that I'm using right now. Now, some of the other options for selfie sticks or monopods or whatever, there's a whole bunch out there, okay? So here's one. I'm not gonna expand these, okay, but this is a 3 meter selfie stick. This one is from Telesin, okay, T-E-L-E-S-I-N. You can find these on Amazon. This is carbon fiber or some kind of a, well, I shouldn't say carbon fiber, but some kind of a fiberglass or something like that. And it's good, it works really well. The only thing here is that it isn't adjustable in between the different extensions. It's held by friction, so you have to pull this out and then, it kind of holds it in place. So if I wanted an intermediate position, I won't be able to do that, okay? So there's some things on this one that I like, and there's some things that I don't like, okay? It's a rather thin end over here, but it works, okay? It will work, for sure. This is another one. This one here is, I forgot where I got this one, but it's just one that is made of metal, and it's a twist lock. So it's not very long, okay, but for everyday use or whatever, it's not too bad. If you look at the height compared to the Manfrotto, okay, it's kind of similar, so you can drop it in your backpack, no problem. And again, there are smaller ones, even a little bit of extension. Okay, this one is actually from Insta360, so this one was for the, you can find these ones online too, but this one was for my 360 camera, but it's not bad. It actually is over this length, it's pretty good, and gives you that extra, meter and a little bit. Again, if you want to go longer, there's this one here. This is another one from Telesin. Okay, it comes with the GoPro adapter and has a quarter 20 thread on the top. Now, this one is really long, okay? You got to kind of, it is a twist lock, so which is great, so that means you can adjust it in between. But I found that some of the sections up here are a little thin, okay? So when you start getting up here, you will get a little bit of wobble, a little bit of bend, but this is a 3 meter pull too, so you can reach really high. This is, almost not, like 9 feet or so. So it does have some really good reach. You have to get up high if you're doing a tractor trailer or something like that. This one would definitely do the trick, okay? So lots of options for poles. You can look at monopods and making your own modifications. Even this, so I found this out. I have this tripod from Small Rig, and one of the legs will pop off. So if I take this and I unscrew it, you'll see that I now have basically a selfie stick. And you're wondering, well, hey, I got this rubber foot on here. And that's true, but what you can do, well, I can show you how long it is first. So it'll extend about that far, okay? But on the very tip here, I can unscrew this, and what I end up with is, if I can get this off, is a 1/4-20 thread. So this is a 1/4-20 thread, which is the standard tripod thread. So basically, this is a 1/4-20 nut, so this would actually adapt. No problem, I can screw that in. So all you need to do is you need to find basically a 1/4-20 thread that you can screw in here and screw it out. You could just buy a regular 1/4-20 screw and just cut the end off, and basically this will adapt to the tripod, the adapter and things like that. So no problem there. But you know, if you want to save, or you know, get some extra value out of a tripod or something like that, you can definitely do that, okay? Great. Other things that you may want to do. So here's one. So on the base of the Manfrotto, and this is the one, like I said, this is my go-to. One thing that you can do is you may want to adapt a little tripod leg. And the reason is when you're holding this thing, once you're done with it, you can't put it down because your phone is on the end. So you may want to just have it resting up. So this is just a little tripod base. I believe this one is from Insta360 as well, just part of the kit. And what you're going to want to do is, I got a problem here because I have a male and a male. I got two male positions. Two males won't go together, at least not with these nuts. So what you need is some kind of an adapter. This is just a threaded nut. It's a 1/4-20 a long nut. It's sort of very long, and I just 3D printed a little cylinder around it. Now you can find these online. There's a bunch of these. It's just a nut, and basically I screw this in here. Okay, like that. And then I can put this in here like that, okay? So then when I'm going to actually scan, I can just close this like that, and I can actually hold it from here and I can do my scanning. This is not a requirement. It's just a little nice to have if you're gonna be putting this down after. You know, I just extend this, put it down, and then I can do something else, whatever, and then I can come back to this, at some time later. Okay, let me take that off and let's move upwards to the adapter. I'll put that back on. So when it comes to the adapters, the one that I'm using right now has integrated swivel, okay? So it'll tilt this way and it'll actually rotate around from the base. Now, if I was using something that did not have that, okay, like just this plastic adapter, it doesn't move or it doesn't do anything else, I may want to put an intermediary universal like ball head, like something like this. And there's a bunch of these that you can get just like that, okay? They just have a little screw at the side that sort of firms them up. And what I would do is I would put this here like that, and then I would basically screw this one in, and that gives me all the adjustment I want. If I want to tilt it down or sideways or whatever, I can do everything I want with this. Now I don't need this because it's already built in, so it's already in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just thread this on like that, and this constitutes pretty much the basic kit here. And you can see I can actually spin this around, okay? So it's built into the adapter, and I can also tilt it back and forth however I want, no problem. So with this here, there are some other options, okay? So we've covered, you know, pretty much the phone versus the iPad, what kind of selfie stick you want to use, and then the adapter. So those are some basics. And now I'm going to talk about lights, okay? There are situations that you get in where having additional lights are going to be really, really helpful. And the reason is you may find yourself in a very bright, sunny location, but the problem is the areas that you want to focus in on are in the shade. And you'd be surprised that you can actually get much better detail and sort of, you know, good color by adding more lighting, so blasting a lot more light. Now, I've done some experimentation with different types of lights and things like that, so I'm not going to go through them all. There's a bunch online you can get, like little puck lights and things like that. Many of them work really, really well. But I have pretty much settled on the Fox Fury lights. Okay, so these are from Fox Fury. They are built rock solid, so I can I throw these around and I need something that's rugged, okay? So I don't want them to break, and these ones are built really, really well. There are different types of these Fox Fury lights, different models and stuff like that. So, and they have a different color temperature, okay? So you can look at the different color temperature. I won't get into these, I'll probably save that for another video, but I would definitely recommend these lights. You're not gonna regret it. They have four different settings for brightness. They have these different lenses that are on here, and at the center here, it's the most diffuse lighting, okay? So I want something that's nice and wide. You could go to a spot, okay, but you don't want to actually have a spot when you work with these, because you want to illuminate everything evenly as best as you can. So doing that is very helpful. Now, in order for, before I mount these, they do have a hot shoe adapter. So for example, I could take this here and actually stick them on just like that. Okay, I could. Now the problem is the two lights, when I put them on, are gonna be very close together, and I wanna sort of separate them a little bit more and maybe even control the way that they're pointing or how they're pointed. So in order to do that, I also have this little offset adapter. So it's a hot shoe on the bottom, it has a 1/4-20 on the top, and what I do is I take the Rugo light and I'm just going to like screw this in the bottom, and it doesn't take much. So once that's in there, it gives me the option to tilt. So there's a swivel over here, and this will bend however I want. So I can actually adjust the lights to different positions. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna put this one in here, like that, let's say. I'm gonna tighten that up. Okay, great. And actually, I'll put the phone in here right now, just so you see it with the phone and how it works. And then I'm gonna take this other light, and I'm also gonna do the same thing. So I'm gonna put that in here, and I'm gonna tighten this one up. And there you go, okay? This would pretty much be the basic kit. So I've got two lights, I can turn those on. 1, 2, again, these are on the low setting, okay? And I can change the direction just by loosening this and then using the swivel to change their position. And you wanna make sure that you look at the app and make sure that you get a good overlap and that sort of thing. I think what I'll do is at some point I'll do another video and just on lights, on these Rugo lights and how you might wanna operate them. But this right here is the basic setup that you get with lights. You got your phone adapter and you have your selfie stick, right? All great. Now, if you're gonna be using targets, okay, we do have a target kit, and I'm just gonna show the one. I did another video on the different target kits that are available. So these ones are the aluminum target kits. So why do you use targets? It's to increase accuracy. So basically, you're gonna lay these out across the object. So if there's a car, you're gonna put one at the front, maybe one at the back, maybe off to like one side of the vehicle. And then you're gonna need a tape measure. And with that tape measure, you're gonna measure the center to center distance as best as possible, okay? As most accurately as you can. And while you're scanning, or just before you're scanning in the settings, you turn on target distance and you enter that value. And it gives the point cloud a tweak, okay? So it helps it with accuracy. Now, these targets can be purchased online. I'm showing you the aluminum targets, which are the more recent one that we have, just two of these. Okay, so they're built tough and they work. And like I said, there's other videos that I have on this. We also do have a kind of like a multi-pack of targets. So they are magnetic targets and even vinyl stickers. And those are for people who want to make their own. Okay. So if you just want to put it on a block of wood, we have a 4-inch target or sticker. We have a 6-inch sticker, and we have magnets, both 4-inch, 6-inch and 8-inch magnets. So it gives you a lot of opportunities there. So when it comes right down to it, if we push all of these aside, let me move everything out of the way. Let me talk to you about what you need as the basic kit, okay? So I'll move this. This is it right here. So we've got selfie stick, we've got the phone adapter, we have two of these offset adapters that go from the hot shoe to the 1/4-20 adapter. We have two Rugo lights here. Of course, you have your phone. You've got two targets, okay, to help you with increasing the accuracy of the point cloud data that you're gonna be collecting, and you're gonna need something to measure the difference between these two, okay, the center to center target distance. And this is pretty much the basic kit, what you would need in order to work with Recon 3D. The lights are optional, so you don't need them if you're going to be working outdoors, and usually it's fairly well lit, no problem, but they do help even in situations where something is in the shade or maybe not very well lit, even if it's bright outside or whatever. Okay, that's it for this one. I want to thank everyone very much, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.